Bishop has been sharing with us concerning Christian conduct. Christian conduct. Amen. And today, I want us to add a few things concerning our this year. We want us to share some feelings concerning very, very important things. One of the things you must learn is that teaching is very important. Teaching is what instills discipline. Discipline. And discipline is what shows us that we are mature. We are mature people because we have discipline. There are things which are done by children where the adult cannot do. When you are grown up, you cannot do. Therefore, I want us to turn in the book of 1 Samuel. 1 Samuel. I believe that the Lord will bless you. The Lord called me. And one of the grace of God in my life is to teach the Word of God. I've been teaching this Word for some time now. Jesus said in the book of John, chapter 8, verse 31, 32, if you continue in my word, he taught those Jews who had believed. So there is believing and continuing in the word. Then you shall be my disciples. Discipleship, being a disciple comes from that word of discipline. And you shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. Amen. So there is continuation for you to experience liberty. In 1 Samuel chapter 3, that's where I'm reading. And the boy Samuel ministered before the Lord and Eli. In those days, the word of the Lord was rare. There were no many visions. One night, Eli, whose eyes were becoming so weak that he could barely see, was lying down in his usual place. The lamp of God had not yet gone out, and Samuel was lying down in the temple of the Lord, where the ark of God was, that is the presence of God. Then the Lord called Samuel. Samuel answered, "Here I am." And they ran to Eli and said, "Here I am, you called me." But Eli said, "I did not call. Go back, lie down." So he went and lay down. Again the Lord called Samuel, and Samuel got up, went to Eli and said, "Here I am, you called me." "My son," Eli said, "I did not call. Go back and lie down." Now Samuel did not know. I want you to underline that verse. Samuel did not know the law. The word of the Lord had not yet been revealed to him. But then the Lord called Samuel at that time, and Samuel got up and went to Eli and said, "Here I am, you called me." Then Eli realized that the Lord was calling the boy. So Eli told Samuel, "Go and lie down, and if he calls you, say, 'Speak, Lord, your servant is listening.'" So Samuel went and lay down in his place. The Lord came and stood there, calling as at the other times, "Samuel, Samuel." Then Samuel says, "Speak, for your servant is listening." Amen. Let's go to the book of John. In the New Testament, in the book of John, chapter 10, which we know, most of us will know it. We are conversant with it. Saint John, for us to see something today, we want to learn something very important. Something very important to our Christian life. We can begin with verses 2. The man who enters by the gate is the shepherd of the sheep. The watchman opens the gate for him, and the sheep listen to his voice. calls the sheep by name and the lightner by name, and leads them out. When he has brought out his own, he goes on ahead of them, and his sheep follow him, because they know his voice, for they will never follow a stranger. In fact, they will run away from him, because they do not recognize, this is, I'm reading from NIV, his voice, and the lightner by name, they do not recognize his voice. Amen. When we began this year, we were given some keys to explosion. And the key number one was preparation. Number two was the mind of Christ, changing our mind, our mentality. Then we had the depth in prayer, that is number three, depth in prayer, will usher us into explosion. Number four was carrying God's presence. I spoke sometimes ago, Bishop has talked about preparation, mind of Christ, depth in prayer. And then number five is hearing God's voice. Number six, high-level of obedience. Reverend Miriam talked and shared with us concerning high-level of obedience. Then we have focusness. And then we have great courage, great courage. Bishop shared with us that. Number nine, actions of faith. He has been sharing so much about actions of faith. And those also have been coming till days. He has been sharing about creativity and work. And today, I want to combine the two. I want to combine what we call the hearing of God's voice and the high level of obedience. I want to share those few. About, I want to have a subtitle by saying the topic is recognizing God's voice, How to recognize, how does God speak to us? Because I believe that is very key to explosion, that is very key to doing exploits. It's very important to understand that to locate the voice of God is very key, it's very important, and then obey. Obedience is carrying instruction to the letter. So I want to share with you about the voice of God, about how God speaks, how to ascertain his voice, how to ascertain his word. Why am I teaching today when I was waiting on God? It is my concern because of today, and because all over where we go to preach, we go to minister, I'm meeting with many pastors, I'm meeting with families, I'm meeting with business people, I meet with many people. Now we realize that many people don't understand the voice of God. I have found many Christians don't recognize, they don't have acid test for the voice of God. And it is very important to understand what Jesus said, that the sheep hear the shepherd, who is Jesus our shepherd, hear the shepherd. He was talking about the sheep and not the lamb. You know, there is a difference between a lamb and a sheep. Now you understand that. A lamb is a baby, may not recognize. He needs to learn the voice of the shepherd for some time to understand the voice, that when the stranger speaks, he won't fall. That's what Jesus said. That verse, it is talks about sheep, not a lamb. When Jesus appeared to Peter, he told him, feed my lambs. So a lamb can be misled. A lamb can follow a stranger because has not learned. They say that a child learned the voice in the time of the mother because of the language. There must be a communication for some time. That even in darkness, you can know. If you stay with someone for some time, there is a sense in you which is developed. When he speaks, you can know. Do you understand? Therefore, when somebody does grow, when you learn, you must learn the voice. And when you learn the voice of God, it is very important. The Bible says in the book of Amos, chapter 3, verse 7, it says, God will do nothing except first he reveals to his servants and his prophets. Everybody who is born again is a servant of God, because he is serving God. Therefore, whatever God wants to do in your life, he first speaks to you. He shows you. That is why we have seen this young man, Samuel, who was the son of Elkanah, and the mother was Anna, lived in the temple where God used to speak. In those days, the Holy Spirit had not been poor, but he could come on people certain times and speak. And therefore, this young man lay where in the presence of God, and Eli was there, and God wanted to speak to this young man. I believe he was a teenager. And here, as we have read, this young man had the voice, but this young man was only familiar with the voice of Eli, but not God. So when God spoke to this young man in an audible voice, like now when we are speaking, God speaks in that way. When he spoke, this young man told it is thought it is Eli, and ran to Eli and told, "You are calling me." And Eli said, "No, I have not called you, God, like that." So later, Eli recognized that this young man, God is calling, and told him when he calls him, because the word of God had not been revealed. This young man had stayed in the temple for the rest of most of his life, since he was a baby. But here, that means you can be in church for a period of time, you can stay in church, but here you cannot discern, you cannot ascertain, you cannot recognize the voice of God. Now I want to shed some light concerning the ways God speaks to us. Many ways God speaks to us. There are so many ways God speaks to us. But today, I want to limit myself to only around 10. If time permits, if it does not permit, I'll share another day, then we shall continue. Why do we need to recognize? Why do we need to know the voice of God? That is what Jesus said, that the sheep know the voice of the, they recognize. The Bible talks about there is a way which seems right in the eyes of men, but the end is death. There are also many other voices in the world. There are so many voices today. There are so many preachers. There are so many people speaking. There are so many books written. Everybody is speaking. Everybody is claiming God has spoken. And therefore, it's good to recognize and to know when God is speaking or when God is not speaking, that we don't fall prey to the enemy. You know, in the Matthew chapter 4, when the devil came to Jesus, he told him, "It is written." He also spoke as God. He said, "It is written also." But Jesus knew the word and said, "It is also written." Therefore, if you are not certain, you are not sure of the voice of God, it is very easy to be deceived. Are we together? Therefore, the Bible says there is a way which seems. Many years ago, over 20 years ago, I had a very wonderful brother. His name was Steve. And one day, what I'm going to share is very important, very spiritual. We used to preach with him. Used to go to meetings. The power of God moves. Heal the sick, cast out devils, pray for the people to be filled with the Holy Spirit. We were a group of brothers. And then, one day, he and his pastor, he was pastoring a church somewhere. And therefore, he went to his pastor and said, "The Lord has spoken to him to marry a certain lady." I inquired of him, I asked him, "Brother, what's the lady? How is the, where is the lady?" He told me, "God has already spoken to me to marry that lady." Well, I don't know the news. This lady had been married in a wedding, and by that time she had two kids. That's not an issue, but she was also pregnant by that time. So when they came, I asked my brother, what has happened? Then I can see your fiancé is pregnant. What is happening? Can you shed more light? He told me many stories, told me, and I asked him, I told him, brother. So we met me and that pastor, his pastor, and then I told him, brother, I don't think that God spoke to you. Because he told me that somebody had impregnated that lady by that time, and then she was pregnant. I asked him, the Bible says, when Joseph discovered that this lady was pregnant, that is Mary, the Bible says he wanted to leave Mary secretly because he feared God. And your God warned him at night and I told him, take your wife, what she has is holy. I asked him, brother, are you sure? Then it went on, they went on. The pastor, sometimes they didn't like me or they liked me, but I told him, my brother, let's pray. Before you take that action, you need to pray more and be sure. I don't think so. I have the Spirit of God, you have the Spirit of God, but I think there is this connection. Either I'm wrong or you are wrong. We cannot all be right. Then the man went on, they organized the wedding, never went on, they married, and they stayed. I went one day to them. The marriage had so many problems. Then of late, to cut the story short, that lady, she was a teacher. They stayed, she got married, the wedding, and that girl was left. What was the problem? It's because this man told God voice, but that was not the voice of God. The Bible says in 1 Corinthians, chapter 14, verse 6, it says, there are so many voices in the world which speak, but you must be able to recognize the voice of God. You must be able to know which is the voice of God and articulate it. In the book of 2nd, I want to give you some verses why we need to know and to recognize the voice of God for explosion. Why? It's because there are so many voices, there are so many people who are speaking, but there are so many ideas in the world, even in the business world, even in our lives, even in our careers. There are many ideas which are not from God. There are things you'll be taught, and if you follow them, you'll fall. If you follow them, you don't succeed. But God wants us to succeed. In the book of Isaiah 14, 17, the Bible says, I'm the Lord, I redeem, who teaches you which way to go and how to make profit. So Christian life is a Christian life, is a Christian of progress. In the book of Proverbs, chapter 4, verse 18, the Bible says, the path of the righteous person, a just man, is like a shining light which shines to the perfect day. The purpose of God is for us to be progressive. It is for us to do exploits. It's for us to have exploits in our lives, to enjoy miracles, signs and wonders every day in our career, in our business, to be promoted, to move from one level to another. The Bible says, faith is revealed from faith to faith, from glory to glory. We grow from glory to glory. And how do we do that? It is when we understand the way God speaks. And I'm going to share in the book of 1 John chapter 4, the Bible says there are so many spirits speaking to you every day. Spirits speaking to you. But you have to distinguish them and the voice of God. You have to know the voice of God. In the book of 1 Thessalonians 5:17, chapter 5, verse 17 to 22, Paul was writing to the church in Thessalonians and he told them, don't despise prophets, give everything. Don't despise the voice of God, but in everything, prove. If that brother had proved, He'd be living happy, but he had not proved. He had a voice, followed the voice, and the voice misled him. The Bible says, even the devil changes to be an angel of light. Over my ears, in preaching the gospel of Jesus Christ, I have heard so many things. I have heard so many people speak. Somebody comes and tells me, I've been called, others have told me, this is the way. But as time goes on, as our sister was teaching, patience, you'll find that what that person was saying was not true. It was not God. You have to realize later it was not God. And that is why you need to teach. You need to recognize and learn the voice of God, that you don't become a victim. That is why every time I tell God, speak to me again. Confirm. Hallelujah. When you hear the word of God, confirm what is God saying. Because if it is God, God will stand behind his word and obey. If it is God, you shall prevail. If it is God, you shall overcome. Amen. You shall overcome. Someone knew that God had called him. He lived a life of success. Was part of almost 40 years. He was a prophet of God. While he had heard God speak to him. In the things of God, there is no guesswork. There is no place of guesswork. You must know that you know God has spoken. Every action we take must be that God has spoken to us. We must prove all this. We must know the sound. Amen. There is a sound for war. There is a sound for rejoicing. That is what Paul says in the book of Corinthians. That the sound, the way it is played, it shows that we are either to going for war or we are going to rejoice. We must understand the voice of God and then recognize the voice of God. And then follow the voice of God. Let me tell you the secret of all great men of the Bible. The secret of all great men today is recognizing, knowing the voice of God and then following the voice of God. When God speaks, every mountain must give way. When God speaks, every obstacle must give way. When God speaks, cancer must obey what he has spoken. It's what we call rain. It is God speaking today. It is God's specific word. The reason why people are standing in their life is not that God is not power, but it's because they are not listening to the voice of God. They are not getting answer from God. God knows where your job is. You need to hear him direct you. And the Bible says to trust in him, he will direct your path. And when he directs your path, success crowns your way. God has not called us to a life of struggle and pain, suffering. Jesus suffered for us. Jesus took our pain. He is our Father. And he wants to give us everything which pertains to godliness. He wants us to have divine health. He wants us to have success. Have happy marriage. Have the blessing of God. Have successful ministry. It is the purpose of God. In that verse where we are read, in the book of John, the Bible says, the thief cometh but to kill, to destroy, and to steal. Anything which connotes stealing and the killing and destruction is not of God, because our God is a good God. God is good, but the devil is bad. That is why anything that does not represent God in your life is not of God. And therefore, the way to come out of stagnation and come to the realm of explosion, what will usher us is when we recognize the voice of God, and that we will not be confused. And someone say, amen. 10 ways God speaks to us. And I want to begin with number one. Number one is circumstances. Many people, God is not limited. We cannot box God in a certain way that God should only speak in this way. God speaks in different ways. But we must recognize and understand how God speaks to us. Many times I have met people, God is speaking to them to change. God is speaking to them to do ABCD. But they are waiting for the voice of God. They are waiting God to speak to them audibly. They are waiting God to give them a prophetic word. But number one, I'm saying God speaks through circumstances. Are we together? We cannot box God. We must have an humble attitude. The way you choose God to speak to me. But if he speaks to me through a very small child, if he chooses that is humility. That is why we must learn to be humble and come to God with no preconceived ideas. The way God will speak to us, the way God will visit us, the way God will trigger explosion. Because God, we cannot box God. God is not a robot. We must humble and receive the word from God, no matter what. And one of the ways I realize many Christians don't understand is they don't realize when God is speaking through circumstances and opportunities. Are we together? Are we together? Hallelujah. Are you understanding? Amen. God speaks to us through circumstances. And I want you to see some scriptures here as we go in the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 16 verse 7 to 9 and Isaiah 45 verse 1. I want to share that. Number one is that God speaks to us through circumstances and opportunities. God speaks. Many people wait God only to speak through an angel. But God speaks most of the time through circumstances, through opportunities. God may be speaking to you, but you must be listening to your spirit. God, you may be praying God, then God opens an opportunity. God creates a circumstance. Here the Bible talks about Cyrus the king. The Bible says, God said, I have anointed you, I have opened nations for you. So God was speaking by opening nations, opening doors for him. Paul says there is an effectual door which is open before me, but there is an adversary. Sometimes we look to the adversary and not to the what God is saying. Why? When a door opens, the devil stands there and opposition and adversaries and the impossibility to show you and hinder you from walking in the purpose of God. He says there is a door. So what was he saying? He was saying, I know it is the will of God. He has opened a door for me. God has opened a way for me. But the adversary is trying to talk me out of the opportunity, out of the circumstances. So we learn that God uses circumstances to speak to us. He uses circumstances to tell us something. He uses opportunity to speak to us. Amen. I have tried to see people trying to force doors to open, which are already closed. God has closed that door. Look, he has closed, but you are pushing it open. They pray. They pray, God, open. Open this door. But you see, you must learn when God has closed the door and leave it. And look to another door. Maybe God is telling you that is not the way. It may be a business. It has come here to pray to God. And then God has just stopped it. You must know that you don't spend your time, all your time trying to force things which cannot work. Where God? Because God knows tomorrow. Amen. So God speaks through circumstances. He shows us through circumstances. Amen. Even when you begin doing things, even our business, he meet the person the first time, even as you go on the bridge, there are signs you will see, there are circumstances which will indicate that this person, this is a breakthrough. Even if God has not spoken to you, you see it. You can see this as an opportunity. God has opened it. Circumstances can show you. If it's a covenant, you see there are things which will begin, God is showing, is speaking to you. If it's a, somebody is just a player, you will know this person, God will show you. That person can, you can stay there for 2 hours waiting for that person. And when he comes there, there's no seriousness. You know that God is warning you, he's sending a signal, he's telling you, no, don't move this direction. God is speaking to you, he's warning you, he's telling you, no. Even as you are financing, the way you plan them, you see there is a loophole here. God is warning you. Even as your business, you find God is speaking through circumstances. Amen. When Joseph went to the house of Pharaoh, when Jacob went to the house of Laban, what happened? He was a man of peace. There was peace, there was prosperity, there was success, there was blessing. Because even those people you employ, if somebody comes and you find things are not moving right, go down and ask God, what is it? Maybe God is speaking through circumstances. He is telling you this person is wrong, you need to do away with. There are people you walk with, your things begin going to disarray. God may not speak with your voice, with his voice, but he's warning you. Since I began living with this person, working with this person, my things are going down. God is speaking to you. Don't wait for another voice. Run away. Hallelujah. You are doing business 1 month, 2 months. That man who was found by Jesus talked about in the book of Luke. He said, just give me 3 years. I put some manure here. I can bait and take care of the vine, even if it does not bring fruit, cut it down. God speaks through our circumstances. He talks to us. He is speaking to us through circumstances. He speaks. And that's one of the most ways God uses to speak to us, to show us circumstances. Things don't happen. Tell somebody, things don't just happen. They are caused to happen. So when you commit your ways to God to direct you, whatever happens in your life, every person you meet, every endeavor you take, there is a purpose for that. The reason for you also being in this church, there is a purpose. You may not have heard any voice of God or an angel, but the fact you are here, God has organized and orchestrated them for you to be here for a purpose. That is enough. The circumstances. Most of the people here did not come because God spoke to them. Maybe they said, I want to be here. They came here and then they are here. You don't have to wait for the voice of God. The circumstances were organized by God in a such a way that you come here and experience the blessings of God. Amen. Circumstances will show us the voice of God. Will speak to us. Opportunities will speak to us. You have money, you see opportunity, God tells you, this is time. Sometimes, just somebody can pop in and tell you, I have a land somewhere. If I mean, can you give me? One of my sons in faith, I told him, I brought him, he's a pastor. He was one of very faithful people in the word of God, doing committed. So one day, a man came and told me, he had himself to do a transport business. He came and he said, I want to go abroad. I have my vehicle here. Give me the money you have. I only need 300. That's because the value, the market value of that vehicle was around 1 million or 800 if you sell it at a draw price. So that man rushed quickly, applied. It was God speaking to him. I have come to bless. He gave him 300. He went abroad. He has been doing that business now for a long period of time. If he missed it, he could continue praying God. Why do we pray? When we come to God, we pray to prepare our hearts before God, that we may hear what he is saying. And when we follow that instruction, explosion comes forth. Somebody say amen. circumstances and opportunities to speak like now. You cannot now go and invest somewhere already you see with your eyes. Common sense tells you. Amen. This is not the right unless God now speaks to you specifically. That is why in chapter 26 of Genesis, this man, Isaac, wanted to go to Egypt. But God spoke to him. If God had not spoken to him when it was in time of famine and tried to show, nothing he could get. Circumstances. You must follow the procedures of life. Somebody say amen. May the Lord give you grace to discern the circumstances and opportunities. Even sometimes where you stay, you might find the landlord is harassing you all the time without any reason. You are buying the devil, but the devil is not going. God is speaking. He is using that person to tell you it's time to change. Move from here. Even your car may be breaking all the time. And they say you pray, you are giving your tithe, you are giving your offering, you are not getting the answer. God is saying you, it is time you believe me. Or no God. Circumstances speak. God uses circumstances to speak to us. Like in the book of John, the Bible says, the waves began to do what? To hit the storm. To hit the storm. Even in a cavern, when you are tying hands, God does not work with you. He's beginning going now. You might say, people are against me. People hate me. People don't love me. But you find God is telling you it's time to change. It is time to shift. You must move from here. You have stayed here for a long period of time. Move. I have something else for you. Jonah was there, but God was telling him where you are going. So what happened? God caused circumstances. He caused the winds to beat the ship to give him the right direction. Some of us, the problem we have is not the devil. It's God originating. It is God who is speaking to you through those circumstances to change. Even in family life, God can use your spouse to square you and then you stay like this. You talk about the devil. No, God is telling you, change. I'm speaking to you through your wife or your husband, your child. God is using that circumstances to speak to you. You are waiting for a prophet to prophesy to you. But God is speaking to you, telling you, you have to change your character. You have to change the way you live. You have to begin to pray. You have to seek God. You have to be humble. God uses circumstances to speak to us. He's speaking to us. He's telling us you have to change. You have to be kind. You have to be humble. You have to listen. Hallelujah. Number two, I know we will not finish today, but when I get tired, I'll continue. Number two is counsel. Counsel. God speaks to you anybody and the counsel. Many people think that God, they go to mountain and they fast 20 years, 21 days, I have fallen. And let me tell you, when you are going to fast, you should come and see the bishop and tell him I'm fasting for these days, pray with me, he sends you to go and fast. Don't just be there. Many people have been possessed with the demons in those mountains. Every time you fast, you open your spirit, wow, to all voices, because you are level, you are high, it's like an aeroplane. You are 2,000 above the earth. So you are prone to many voices. You are prone to demons. You are prone to funny spirits. Because you draw attention in the spirit realm when you begin fasting and the prayer. Do you know when Jesus was fasting is when the devil came to speak? Have you not read? Do you read your Bible? In the book of Matthew chapter 4, it was when Jesus was fasting. Don't think because you are fasting that the devil is scared of you, my friends. He will come. So when you are fasting, it's good to communicate to the servant of God that then blesses you and that tells you, go in peace, my daughter, as you fast and pray these few days. It is not see people follow this that you are not telling him to know. You are telling him because you recognize him as authority. To take care of you, that in any eventuality, you are under protection. So you tell him, man of God, I'm going for it. Many people, all the days in in my ministry, preaching the gospel, I have found many people go there, they get possessed with the demons. They come back when they are full of demons. They are confused, messed up. Amen. So counsel. You need counsel of men who are men of God. In that case, if you are a business person, you need a business consultant, isn't it? If you are sick, you need a doctor. It's good to seek counsel. Maybe Christians say, I have believed they believe God, but also God has sent people. The Bible says, let's look, there are things which are very important to us. It is good to seek counsel and advice, even before, even when God has spoken to you, it is good to seek second opinion. Hello? The kings are wise. The other day you saw that the king had advisors. You cannot excel, you cannot break through without advisors. You cannot experience explosion without the voice of the counselors. You must have people who are advising you. Even in the business world, you need people to advise you. Even it's concerning money, you need people who are experts on that, who are skillful to tell you. And the kings were wise. And that's why Jesus said, the people of this world are wiser than those of light, because we have become so spiritual. Whatever that all of us say, yes, those are good. But you need advice. You need someone to advise you. If you are in ministry like me, there are people who have gone ahead of you. You don't have to suffer what they suffer. They can tell you, my brother, don't follow this road, I followed it, I failed. Don't beat your wife, I beat my wife, I failed. Women don't hear because you beat them. They are brother. You reason. Somebody say amen. You need someone who has brought up children who are handled. He will tell you when children are handled, you reason with them, you show them facts. And you pray for them. You don't beat them. You beat one, goes away. Come here and say the devil. Where is the devil? It's you. The greatest enemy of explosion is us. Counsel is very important. It's very important to consult every decision you make. Why? Let me show you the scriptures. The Bible says in the book of Proverbs 15:22. Can we check there? Check me, Mr. Ramon, even the time goes off. I can stop. We cannot finish this Bible one day. We need to hear it again and again. Hallelujah. Counsel is very important. There are people who don't take advice. And the most of our Christians, you tell many Christians, they don't take advice. That's why they are in problem. It's not the devil, it's them. Because they cannot take advice. Amen. You tell someone, be saving little money, that's not. When Sunday, when hard time comes, they cry. 15:22, Proverbs 15:22-23.
Because you fail, you give you a bad counsel.
Many people have failed in marriage, in life, in business, because of the wrong counsel. You need to see, even in investment, don't invest like you are hiding. If you don't know about the land, go to people who know land, one, two, three, consult from different people. Calm down, sit down, and analyze this in the wisdom and the prayer of God. Get the right answer. Don't just go and buy a land there, you find it has been bought by somebody else. By the time you build, the whole building is broken down. What did you lack? Counsel. Because God speaks through counselors, through counsel, through advice. When I was in Kisi, I was praying for another man who was an MCA. This man went at all his benefits. He went at the boat alive. Just after he has built somebody's car, claiming that he is an original type of it. While he had sought for counsel, he will not fall into such prayer. If you are not good in finances, you can be good in speaking in tongues, casting devils. Speak somebody who is a financial expert on that area. At least two or three, consult them. God is speaking through them. Are we together? You will not fail, you will succeed. You will have explosion. Counsel is very important. Seek counsel, seek spiritual counsel. Amen. Another verse is 24:16. The Bible says, in multitude of counselors, not only one, in multitude, they are receptive. Seek from different people their opinion. Seek second opinion, and then the Lord will bless you. That is Proverbs 24, verse 6, and also Proverbs 11:14. Amen. Amen. And Isaiah 41:28. The Bible says, I wish they were in the castle. Then go to God. Now, I've been told this and this. I've been counseled this. What is your opinion? The Lord will show this is the way. This is the right. And the Lord will bless you. May you get the grace to listen. The grace to seek advice. Even when I came here, before I came here, I did not just come. I sought God, the man of God. I had prayed, I had asked God. But I sought counsel. I asked them. Some told me this, some told me this. Even when I was married, I sought counsel. You must seek counsel. You must have people who advise you. People who think, people who are outside the box where you are, to give you sober advice. And then you shall, explosion shall become the order of your life. Amen. You cannot go down when you have the right counselor. The Bible says there is safety. Even when you are married, don't die, die. Don't die, die. Don't die, die. One pastor, my friend, came here in Nairobi and come from all the rural area. So when they come, you know, the sisters in Nairobi, even if she has three, four children or she's married, you might think it's a girl. No. It's only people of Nairobi know how to take care of themselves. So this guy is full of the Holy Spirit, a good man of God. Then he came and told me, hey, brother, I feel like that is sister. I told her, no, that sister is married, brother. That is not the Spirit of God. Before he messed up, if he could have now gone and is a church like this, pastors come, he has approached someone, his wife to marry, what would have been a mess? That God, he sought some advice. He said, oh, I want to marry. I told her, no, my brother, God has not spoken. That sister is married. She has three children. So it is good to seek counsel. Before you take action, consult in a spiritual way. Amen. Hallelujah. That is number two. The time is going. Number three. It is what we call inner peace. Somebody say inner peace. Inner peace, inner peace. The Bible says God will lead us in peace. Anything which disturbs your peace, not of God. Any opportunity which disturbs your peace. How do we know? How do I know? Peace is paramount. God, we call God, God of peace. God of peace. God, when God, sometimes you think about something and God gives you peace. Peace is an evidence of the presence of God. Peace is an evidence God is directing you. God, you want to do something and then you find you have peace and joy. You find you have peace concerning that. You sit down with somebody, you talk, you have peace. But if you feel disturbed,
Even those people who have been called, you find somebody gives you a very big deal. But as you continue, you have nothing. Not nothing. Sometimes you have nothing in the morning, but their eyes are on the big money. You find that now. That's how people are called. But if you follow your spirit inside the spirit of God, inside your spirit, the Holy Spirit does not leave you. He leads you inside. You listen from the inside. You pray in other times and then you feel the peace of God. You feel peace in your spirit. That God is directing you. God will direct you with peace. Amen. You have peace. You have peace. What you are trying to do, what you have decided to do, you have peace. But if you have disturbance, you are disturbed in your heart. Fast, hold on. Hold on. Hold on. God is, there is a signal of danger. God leads us to peace. Some of you, when you came to this church, you had a lot of peace. That day, you went and slept well because God was speaking to you. This is it. You must have peace of your spirit. In your spirit, God will lead us with peace. I want to go quickly. That you can find it. We have inner peace in the book of Proverbs, chapter 20, verse 20. There is a deceit in the heart of boastful, not evil, but joy for those who promote peace. That's one part. There is joy. Those who have peace, they have joy. In the book of Isaiah 48:18, 26, Isaiah verse 3 says, he has perfect peace, whose mind is stayed in God. He shall have peace as a river. When God is directing you, is leading you, he leads you with peace. God will not lead you where there is no peace. God will not lead you where you are disturbed, you have no peace, you cannot sleep at night. You have a business here that can be challenged, but you should sleep at night as a baby and wake up in the morning as a lion. You have a marriage, but you should sleep as a baby, wake up. Challenges may be there, but you have peace. Peace is a signal of the leading of God. When Jesus was in the boat, the storms were around him. But Jesus was asleep. Why? He had a peace. There was peace in him that he will cross over the issue. He will cross over. So peace is one of the ways God leads us. It's one of the ways God speaks to us. Somebody can come to you and talk many things, but you find that he is talking. There is no peace. He's saying, that's a lie. That's a lie. He's deceiving you. He's cheating you. He's not telling you the truth. There is no peace. You are disturbed. What he is thinking, you ask him, when will he stop that and may go? Why? Because the peace of God, God is telling you, this person, get away. What he's telling you is not a true person. You can embark on a journey and say, I'm going home. And when you are going, as you go, you want to abort that vehicle, you feel no peace, you get out. The Lord is making you warning you, don't get to it. Sooner or later, you get that. It was involved in an accident. Peace. God will lead us through peace. Every voice of God is accompanied by peace and the joy and not sadness. You can see in Colossians 3:15. You can also Philippians 4:7. You can see Genesis 41:16 about Joseph. The Bible says that he had peace. Pharaoh was not at peace when he interpreted the dream for him. Amen. That peace is what shows us that we are in the right direction. Isaiah 41:28, we shall have peace as a river. When you are doing, when God has spoken to you, you are sure there is peace. There might be no peace around, but within you, there will be peace. In your heart, you shall know, this is true, God. I have heard your voice. God, I have heard your voice. There is peace in you. Amen. Somebody say amen. May the Lord help you. May he give you grace. May you be led with peace. That whatever you go, whatever you do, whenever God speaks to you, may you be surrounded with peace. There will be no disturbance, but you shall walk in peace of God.
You shall do your things in peace. There will be peace in your family. There will be peace in your place of work. God will give you peace wherever He directs you to go. God cannot send you somewhere and then there is no peace. Whatever He sends you there will be peace. When you stand there, you are peace. There will be peace. God will give you peace where He has directed you. Those people might be evil, may not be saved. The Bible says, when the ways of a man please God, He gives him peace even in the enemy. They may be eaten, they may be. But God will cause peace in your heart and the peace around you. Shall not live a life of disturbance. You shall not have answers. You shall not have anxiety and worry. God will give you peace because the Bible says the blessing of the Lord make it rich and have no sorrow. There will be no sorrow. The absence of sorrow is peace. Shalom. Shall mark your path. As you follow God and the leading of God, peace marks your path. God removes every headache on your way. God silences opposition. That you may have peace in your life. That you may have peace whatever you do. And I pray today in the name of Jesus that God will give you peace. He will lead you with peace. Whatever is disturbing your life, your career, your destiny, may it cease from today in the name of Jesus. May the Lord lead you with His peace that you may enjoy the explosions of 2018. That shall be your portion in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Number four, as I finish, the other five is for another day. Amen. God speaks through people. Somebody say, God speaks through people. Many times I realize God speaks through people. It is good to listen to people. They might be a preacher. He might be a preacher like me. He might be a prophet. Or he might be ordinary. Many years when I was a young boy, one of my neighbors told me, you know what? One day I see you preaching the gospel in many nations of the world. It's a sinner, it's not sin. But this man, God even uses sinners. Let me tell you, many people don't know. All creation belongs to God. God uses even sinners. Me, I have been blessed by a sinner. People who don't know Christ. He tells me, I feel God, and they don't know God at all. I feel I should do A, B, C, D. Well, those who know God cannot listen to God. You know, God will use, God used a donkey, isn't it? Did God use a donkey? What about human beings? So God can use people to warn you. God can use people to tell you this and this is wrong. If you continue, you say, God, you never spoke to me, but I told you. You can just be driving open and somebody else, the route you are taking is not dangerous, don't take. And you say, like I'm walking in my bed, like that. What you meet there? Somebody can talk to you the way you are having weight. Reduce my friend. You are going to get diabetes. Or high blood pressure. You say, when I'm in bed. That is foolishness. You need to check on your health, on your habits. Are we together? God uses somebody to speak to you. And I want to show you some scriptures as I close in the book of Acts of the Apostles, chapter 21, verse 10 to 11. It talks about Paul wanted to go to Jerusalem. There came a prophet by the name of Agabus. He took the belt of Paul and tied around this and said, "Thus saith the Lord." The owner of this belt, you know, Paul was an apostle. But Agabus, he was just a prophet, just maybe he was not well much known. But it's good to listen to the word of God. What you think is the word of God, not the person. Don't look the vessel. Don't look the vessel which God will use. God can use anybody. Do you hear me? God can use anybody. Even He can use your enemies to bless you. God can use anybody. Hey, hallelujah. So, Agabus took the belt and the tied and the saints that say, that saith the Lord, the honor of this belt, when he goes to Jerusalem, he shall not be bound like the way. That saith the Spirit. But God said, I will go.
Did not the Jews throw him away? Did they not bind him? Did they not beat him? What did he have reason? Would not. Would have escaped. Paul said, I know. He said, I know, I'll go there. And they went there and they were given some beatings. This way. So God used these people to speak to you and then you disobey. When you disobey, you suffer. When you suffer, you cry to God. God is merciful. But you have already suffered what you could have escaped. Hallelujah. The same chapter, Acts of the Apostles, 23, verse 12 to 16. It is talks about the Jews decided that Paul be brought before the court the following day, before the Sanhedrin. And then they had decided there were 40 people who had fasted and they prayed. And they said, we will not eat and you will kill Paul. And they tore him into pieces. 40 vowed, we will not eat or drink and you will kill Paul. Those are animals. You know, even today they are people who fast. That you may die. They fast. That you may end. Don't take chances like in life, don't take chances. Not everybody who loves with you wishes you the best. These people, the nephew of Paul heard. He had them speaking, saying, we are going to kill. That is what the Bible says in Ecclesiastes. Don't gossip a king, lest a man hear and go to the palace and tell the king. This is the Bible. Don't gossip the king, lest a man hear you and goes to the king, to the man and tell the king, I heard so and so speak so. God uses people to speak to us, to hear it. So, don't ignore anything you hear. Don't ignore. I say don't ignore, even in your place of work, don't ignore. Even in your business, it may be a rumor or gossip, but God may be speaking. This nephew of Paul had the Jews because Paul was now under harvest. And they could not look. He heard the Jews say, tomorrow we are asking the court to release him. And when he releases, we are bound for 40. We will not eat or drink. 40 men who had eaten well. We will tear him into pieces. And his destiny will be scattered. Those were demons who had possessed this man. But then this God made me sure, even if he does not speak to Paul, he will check the humility of Paul. His nephew had, and went to Paul and told him, sir, do you know what is the plot? The plan is to finish you tomorrow, you'll be told. Then Paul talked to the authorities and it never happened. They took him by a basket and they came down and he was delivered. God will speak through people. They will come and they tell you the market. It's not good for today. It will bring this problem and this problem. Listen. Amen. Learn to receive criticism. Even when people say you are not good at this, don't just take it as negative. Constructive criticism is healthy. Amen. That is why Jesus asked people, as the disciple, whom do people say I am? Some say this, some say this. It is good to listen to people. No man is an island. Listen to people. Listen to the negative things and the positive things and take them positively. If Paul would not have listened to this young man, he could have died following him. And then people would say, oh God, it took him. No. The Bible says in Ecclesiastes, be wise. Why should die before your time? You can die before your time. Your life can be messed up before your time. Not because God wants, but because you are not. That is why David said, as I close in the book of Psalms, he leadeth me. That is where we are now reaching. Amen.
Let me just mention number five and we finish. God speaks through dreams and visions. God speaks through dreams and visions. God speaks through dreams and visions, which I know you know. And you can see it in Matthew 1:12, when an angel appeared to Mary and told them, leave this town, leave this place. Heaven is looking for you. Go to a place through a dream. God spoke to Joseph, don't throw away your wife. And therefore God speaks through visions and dreams. Do you have dreams? How many have dreams? How many have visions? Do you dream? How many dream? Have you ever had a dream? A spectacular dream. Dreams are, God speaks through dreams. So every dream you dream, don't take it lightly. That's what I want to say. Every vision you see or dream you dream, don't take it lightly. Don't ignore it. Don't look at it. God speaks through visions and the dreams of our witness. God speaks through dreams and the visions. I dream. I said, I have visions. I operate in that. I operate in the dream and the vision. I dream. If I finish 1 week without dreaming or having a vision, I feel I have to seek God to know what is happening. Visions are key in the book of Joel, chapter 2, verse 20. The Bible says in the last days when God will do a spirit, he will speak to us through vision and the dreams. Amen. Dreams and the visions God speaks to us are very important. God will show you data in a dream. The wise men were shown not to go through that way in a dream. Don't go. Vision and the dreams are very important. God speaks to us through visions and the dreams. Many people ignore. Maybe if I tell you even many visions I have seen and the dreams, you'd be shocked. Amen. Some I can't tell you, but they are vision. God shows me a vision and a dream. 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 Just during the day, he shows me a vision. He will show me. Just show me what is happening. Even about this nation and other nations in the world. He shows God speaks through vision. You must embrace vision. Amen. You must embrace dream. Thank God for our bishop and the man. Here we believe in the Holy Spirit. We believe in the Word of God. We believe in the manifestation of the Holy Spirit today. Amen. God speaks to us through vision and the dream. But after you see the vision and the dream, you must scrutinize, you must test the vision. You must test the dream. If it is God or Satan, because also Satan shows people dreams. Also witches bring dreams. Some people have been shown, somebody can see the bishop or the pastor chasing you. That is not the dream of God. That's the devil. Or your husband killing you. Yes, it's good to pray, but you can see this is just a lie of the devil. Then you begin thinking your husband is evil. The Bible says when men slept, the enemy sowed a seed. Also, through dreams and the vision, the devil sowed seeds of discord and the confusion. But also, you love peace, you love joy when it is of God and it keeps recurring. Like Nebuchadnezzar was traveling. Then you see cancer. You don't just begin saying, I dreamed, I had a vision. Some people just say, you ain't somebody, you sleep at night. Then you have a vision, not a dream. That is not of God. Are we together? But God speaks through vision and dream. Let's read Psalms 23 as I close now. Something very important. Psalms 23. Can we read it together? Psalms 23. The Lord is my shepherd. That means he'll lead you. I shall not be in want. Whatever the Lord leads you, you don't lack. One of the signs that God is with you, you don't lack. Hello? The shepherd makes sure you don't lack. You don't lack. When God leads you, you don't lack. Amen. You don't lack help.
When God leads you somewhere, you find it, as you pop in, say, there are people who God has prepared to help you. There are people who are prepared to receive you. There are people who are prepared to bless you. Why? Because God has gone ahead of you. That's why David said, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not be in want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. Where does he cause you to lie? Green pastures. One of the signs that God is leading you is green pastures. He leads you beside quiet water. That he gives you peace. You have quietness. You have peace. Eh? He restores my soul. He guides me in the path of righteousness. That means God will not lead you to sin, to evil. Even though I walk through the valley of death, the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. You have no fear, for he is with me. You are on and the staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Even before the enemies, when God leads you, he tells you, keep this enjoying, let the enemies continue watching you. So when God leads you and is with you, enemies have no power over you. You just look at them. And then God tells them, watch my son as he enjoys. And watch my daughter as he enjoys. And she enjoys because the Lord leads you. He anoints me with oil. That is the presence of God. One of the things to know that God is leading you is to feel and experience his presence. Every time I feel the presence of God lifted now, I know that God is not there. You feel the presence of God, even in our vision, not our dream. You feel the presence. There, everybody knows. There is that atmosphere of God. You know, the presence of God is with you. That is the assurance that God has spoken to you. Surely, my cup overflows. It is overflowing. You are overflowing the peace and the grace of God. Surely goodness and the love will follow me all the days of my hallelujah and the dwelling in the house of the Lord. Everything which takes you away from the house of God is not God. Every voice which takes you away from God, from the house of God, from fellowship is not the voice of God. The voice of God draws you nigh to the house of God, where you may see his goodness. It does not draw you away from the house of God. How do I know? My desire, when God speaks to me, my desire for him increases. My love for him increases. My purity increases. I want to live for him. That is the voice of God. I recognize, because every voice calls me to himself. That's how I know. Hallelujah. Those are five. We shall continue from there. Can we stand on our feet? Today we need the grace to recognize the voice of God. When God speaks, we must obey. Reverend Miriam taught us, God demands high level of obedience. Explosion is not also hear and do. In the book of Deuteronomy 28, if you shall diligently hearken and obey my voice, this blessing shall come and overtake you. Obedience to the voice, to the instructions of God, what usher us into the realms of explosion. There are things we don't pray for. God gives us freely when we obey him. When we obey his voice, there are things we don't pray for. God just gives us easily. Why? He is leading us and we are following him. Today I want you to make a commitment in your life for the rest of the 6 months. They can make a turnaround in your life upside down. If you learn to obey God today, when you learn and recognize the voice of God and diligently obey God's voice, your life, your path will be marked with exploits. You'll become a man of exploits and a woman of exploits. The reason I'm in Nairobi is because God spoke to me. Therefore, whatever I speak, it is in my domain. God has to inform me. When I tell that sickness to die, it has to die. Why? He called me. I'm not guessing. I'm not assuming. I'm not Hallelujah. When God speaks to you, you enter in the realm of authority. You will enter in the realm of anointing. That when you, whatever you say must come to pass. Whatever you decree must come to pass. Authority. Anything God speaks, it will prevail against any opposition in life. When he said there, be like devil was there, but he cannot stop it. When God has spoken and you carry the word, it is over. It is over. When you locate the word of God, it is over. When God said, Abraham, I will bless you, it was done. When you cut the voice of God, it is done. No matter who stands on your way, God will clear them. No matter what comes, you shall prevail when you recognize and listen to the voice of God. No demon, no witch, they will be there, but the God will tell you, enjoy in the presence of your enemies, because God is in charge. Let's lift our hands before the Lord this morning. Tell the Lord, mighty God, forgive me where I have not heard you. Forgive me where I have missed your voice. Forgive me where I have missed you, Lord, have mercy on me. Give me the grace to obey you. God is speaking. Many people are looking for God to speak, but God is speaking. The Bible says, let who has ears hear what the Spirit is saying to the churches. That means the Spirit is speaking, even concerning that problem you have, that challenge. God is speaking. You need to listen to him and take instructions. Take instructions. And as you take instructions, exploits shall be the result. As you take instructions, your health will come back. Some of you, you need to change your diet. Some of you need to change your habit. Some of you need to stop thinking, overthinking so much. Some of you need to change the way you do things. Some of you need to repent and turn away from sin and turn away from wickedness in the name of Jesus. And then as you obey the Lord, just let the Lord, Father, we thank you. Just speak to the Lord, open your mouth, speak to the Lord. Speak to the Lord, tell the Lord to give you the grace. May the Lord give you grace to listen. May God give you the grace to hear his voice. I pray today in the name of Jesus that you shall receive the grace. Receive the grace to hear the voice of God. Receive the grace to follow the voice of God. See, receive the grace of God to follow his word, to follow him, to hear him, to hear him. I pray for your antenna, your spiritual antenna to be lifted, to be positioned to hear the voice of God. From today in the name of Jesus, every voice of Satan, every voice of confusion, every voice of hell, I silence it permanently in the name of Jesus. And I connect you with the voice of the Spirit of the living God. I connect you with heaven. From today you shall receive signals. Those who have lost signals, they have not had God. I pray in the name of Jesus today that you shall begin hearing God. You shall see vision. You shall see dreams. God will speak to you concerning the issues which are challenging you in your career, in your family, in your life, in your destiny, in the name of Jesus. From today, I declare it over. In Jesus.